I am under no laws but God's laws, and herein is my freedom. You can say that throughout the day. I am entitled to live under God's laws, God's rules, and those rules and laws only. Because God created me, and therefore I am under God's laws, not any other laws. This is a statement of freedom. It's very important as we get ready for Hell Week, which is the last week of June, going into, I think, the 1st of July, where so many tipping events are going to take place, that we stipulate what we're entitled to. We are entitled to live under God's laws and God's laws only. And of course, God's laws are entirely benevolent. They provide us with infinite riches, infinite perfect stability, perfect peace, perfect calm, invulnerability, eternal life, and on and on and on. Perfect, flawless. We're entitled to live under those laws. Statement of freedom. We need to make statements of freedom now, because the laws and rules of this world, we made all of those. The way that nature works, we made that. We've made all of this up through our spiritual imagination, through our desire to create a separate reality. And we believe that we have to live under these laws, etc. We must do this. Not so. We are entitled to live under God's laws, because God created us. We are a creation of the Prime Creator. So that's very good news. But we must begin to make this statement like 1,000 times a day. I'm entitled to live under God's laws and God's laws only. And the laws of the world are losing their grip on me. I'm entitled to be free of the grip of any other laws or rules. Crucial at this time to make statements of freedom. I'm entitled to live under God's laws. That's my entitlement. Again, I say we're pre-qualified to do this. We're entitled to it. Inherently entitled to it. Inherently pre-qualified. We don't have to do anything to justify. We're entitled to it, so we don't need to justify it. We don't need to excel under the ego's laws, the laws of this world. We don't need to have somehow prospered and excelled under these crazy laws. We don't need to appear to be someone really special under these laws. We're inherently, everyone is inherently entitled to live under God's laws and God's laws only. Again, totally beneficent. No sickness, no death, no dying, no aging, no vulnerability, no separation, no loneliness, no despair. No troubles like that, only the rich tapestry of experiencing. We're entitled to that. Absolutely must say this as an affirmation now. It's affirmation time. As we go into Hell Week, it's affirmation time. I wish I could do more for everyone to know this fact. We're going from theory now into affirmation. Affirmation is a higher type of functioning. Theory is very important. Affirmation is more powerful. It's like when you're trying to drill through concrete using a concrete drill bit, and you're going kind of slow and you're gradually working your way through, and then you say, wait a minute, let me just go from this drill to a rotohammer, which drills and then also pounds like a jackhammer. Pow, 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 pow. So it's both drilling and pounding. And that way you just go, you go through the concrete like butter. So theory is like drilling a hole through concrete. You make progress and you're getting there. But affirmations are like using a roto drill. Hammer drill. with drilling with that hammer, hitting a drill, pow, 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 and you just go right through it. That's affirmations, pow, pow, pow. I'm entitled to live under God's laws only. I have perfect entitlement. I'm perfectly pre-qualified. I'm already a full, I've always been a full, perfect member of the Kingdom of Heaven, perfect membership in the Kingdom of Heaven, full rights and privileges, irrevocable membership, have eternal membership, irrevocable eternal membership with full rights and privileges. I'm entitled to live under God's laws only. Because the grip of the world must slip from its grasp. Because its grasp is going to become very, very strong. Affirmations are like spraying WD-40, you know, to loosen the grasp of the ego. Grasp of the world's laws so that you can slip from its grasp. Affirmation time. Hell Week is a situation where a lot of decisions are being made that nobody's going to be happy. There's going to be more and more polarization, more and more agitation, more and more consternation. And, you know, things are just going to heat up. You have so much now on the plate. And in order to try and keep that agitation under wraps, calm down, more and more laws will be passed, more and more strict rules and regulations. And it's time to assert our independence, our freedom from the rules and laws that we made up, that we thought would take the place of God's rules and laws. That we thought would trump God's rules and laws, that we believed would countermand God's laws and rules. We believe that our laws and rules would replace God's laws and God's rules. And fortunately, none of that is true. So we tried to construct a separate reality with its own rules and own laws. But this in no way disqualified us from our what we're entitled to in our membership in the Kingdom of Heaven. We're citizens, we're free citizens of the Kingdom of Heaven. Born that way, created that way. No laws or rules can change that. What we make up can change that. We cannot make up some rule like we decree that we have been disqualified from citizenship in the Kingdom. That law, that rule has no bearing, no weight, no authority. We can believe and have faith that it has authority, which is what existence does. Existence is simply a belief and a faith that the laws and rules that we've made up, the decrees that we have declared, have authority, some weight or authority in reality. They don't. They only grip us as long as we still want to believe in them. And but they have no weight or authority whatsoever in reality. So again, I am entitled to live under God's laws. I am entitled to live under God's laws. That is declaration of freedom. And I tell you right now, a new freedom. Freedom. True freedom. Let's say true freedom is absolutely essential. Because this world is going to plunge into enslavement. going to plunge into darkness. It's going to take the plunge. Look, if you have someone, let's say there's an Olympic swimming pool and there's a diving board, and you have a diver on the board, and you know how they jump up on the springboard, and they jump on again, it springs them higher, then they jump again, and they go even higher, and they're getting ready. You know when they take that last third, you know, spring off the springboard, and they're in an arc, you know they're going to come down and dive into the pool. So it's like the world has been on this springboard, and each time they come on the springboard, it bends more, flexes more, and propels them even higher. So the world has been going like this, up and down, getting higher each time. And then finally now the arc is over the pool, and you know it's going to plunge into the pool. It's completely obvious where the world is headed. And, you know, I'd say majority of the people of the world understand this, because intuitively they can feel it, they know it. It's no secret. So the key is to affirm freedom from the world, which is just a set of fantasy rules and laws and objectives and agendas. Just a fantasy. The world is is nothing but a pretense, a fantasy, a what-if scenario. What if we could build a separate kingdom? What if we could become prime creators? What if we could just... It's up to us to establish what we are, what the rules are. We're the creators. We're the prime creator. It's all fantasy. And of course, in order to keep this fantasy going, it has to become more and more strict. Gotta tighten everything up. Have to keep investing in delusion. Keep believing we're under some alien set of rules and laws. But we are under no laws except God's laws. We're entitled to live under God's laws. Absolutely entitled to that. So make declarations of freedom. Now, like anyone who's struggling to do right, I'm trying to follow my own advice. And, I can tell you already, I had a remarkable event take place simply from that simple declaration. I'm entitled to live under God's laws, and God's laws only. And spending a day repeating that and focusing on it, I felt a grip of the world. I felt the world's grip on me slip away. I experienced that for a moment. I said, what was that? Someone lost their grip on me, you know, something lost their grip on me. Some very harmful influence. Some influence that's been trying to control me and insisting that I live under their rules and their laws. They lost their grip. It's kind of surprising because we don't realize we're in the grip of something, but we are. We're really being manipulated and controlled and in the grip of those who want to pretend to be prime creators, want to continue this pretense that they have a separate kingdom, a separate reality, and they want to rule over that reality. They want to be the rulers of a new separate reality. And so everyone is enslaved to that purpose. Everyone is gripped and told you must work for that purpose. Well, we are entitled to get free from that grip, to slip from that grip, and live only under God's laws, which are totally beneficent for us. We're absolutely entitled to that. We have full membership in reality, in the kingdom of heaven. We're entitled to all the benefits of this membership. We're entitled to live under the conditions that God's law set forth. Absolutely entitled to that. Right? That is like a laser photo hammer, laser. Just make that intention like a laser. Not all kind of, not begging. Don't beg. Assert it. I'm entitled to live under God's laws. I'm entitled to it. You're not asking a question, am I entitled to it? And so I am entitled to it. Perfectly entitled to it. Always entitled to it. I insist I live under God's laws only. That's my assertion, see. Start pushing that out in your personality, in your persona, in your mind, in your spirit. Start asserting that. Start being assertive in that way. No more mushiness. No more pleading, praying, begging, whining, hoping, pining, sighing, suffering. Cast that all aside. Let that lose its grip on you. We are entitled. I say we. You can say I. We also. Everyone is entitled to it. We are entitled to live under God's laws and God's laws only. Of course, when you say, I am, I is one. There's one sonship, one spirit with many facets to it, but it's all one. Like a diamond with many facets, it's still one diamond. So if we assert our entitlement, we're asserting the entitlement for the entirety, the totality of it. Everyone is saved with us. Everyone we're asserting everyone's entitlement when we assert our own. So we can still work with our own entitlement and say, I am entitled. And say it with conviction, determination. I am entitled. I am perfectly entitled. Right now, I'm entitled to live under God's laws and rules only. I'm entitled to that. Assert your entitlement right now. Don't need to shout it. You know, don't need to make a big display of it. You don't even have to say it out loud. Now, any situation that arises in the world, say, this situation has no grip on me because I'm entitled to live under God's laws and rules. It would be nice to, if there was some kind of worldwide movement of asserting one's freedom, one's entitlements, one's true entitlements, to escape the demands of this world. You see, the world is insisting that we work on the world's entitlements. The world's insisting that it has a right to, it's entitled to be a separate reality. To establish itself as the reality. So the world is demanding that we all slave away for its false entitlements. We need to assert our true entitlement. We're born of the Prime Creator, born into the kingdom. We're entitled to dwell in the kingdom. We're entitled to live under the rules and laws of the kingdom. And it would be a great thing if we were able to start a movement of an entitlement movement, people making this assertion. Maybe we can say we're entitled to amplify this assertion. Who knows? Maybe it could take place. I hope it will. People getting together and making this entitlement assertion together, amplifying it, reinforcing it for one another, keeping it simple, very, very simple. That'd be a great thing to do, and But each one of us needs to assert it for ourselves right now. Who knows? Maybe such a thing could take place. Maybe it will take place. But don't wait for it to happen. We must assert it right now. Start with, look in the mirror and start right there. I am entitled to live under God's rules and laws only. And those rules and laws are entirely beneficent. And free me from all the bizarre, strange rules and laws that I've invented for myself. That I've made up out of thin air for myself. All in an effort for me to be prime creator. See, Spirit wanted to be prime creator. Wanted to have a separate kingdom. Wanted to be the author of a new reality. Therefore insisted that it somehow was free of God's kingdom. No longer lived under those rules and laws. I've forgotten all about it. But this is just in a dream, a fantasy. The Spirit is still totally one with the kingdom. Full privilege is there. Eternal membership. Irrevocable. Cannot be disqualified. Even through its own decrees, cannot be disqualified. Spirit cannot just sit up there and say, I decree that I am no longer a member in good standing of the kingdom of heaven. I've been disqualified, and therefore I'm going to go create a new reality, new kingdom for myself. Spirit can make these arrogant decrees, but they have no authority over reality whatsoever. And only in dreams do they seem to have authority. But a dream has no authority over us. See, I'm entitled to live under God's laws and rules only, and there's no law or rule that of dreaming in reality. So we're entitled to get free of the crazy laws and rules that arise in a dream. In our dream. We're entitled to slip through their grasp totally. Be free of it forever. This is a fact. We do have that entitlement because we were created by the Prime Creator to be co-creators. Completely invulnerable. There's no vulnerability. There's no change. There's no modification in reality. It's invulnerable. No destruction, no breaking down, no fragmentation. It's one wholeness, one oneness. It's all one. There's no separate fragments. There's no air, no fragment, nowhere that is under different laws. Laws of separation, laws of fragmentation, laws of destruction. There's nothing like that. Only in a fantasy can such things be imagined. And we're entitled to be free of all that imagining. We're entitled to live under God's rules and laws. So I wonder if we cannot shift into a mode of assertion, affirmation. I'll put it out there. We've gone through a year of theory here. Of intense, intense theory. So I'm considering this possible new direction. To keep up with the times. Because the world is going to go into overdrive right now. This fantasy we call the world is going to pound its chest and assert that everyone must redouble their commitment to it, the laws and rules of this of existence. No question that's going to take place. But it's been leading up to that point. So many more laws and restrictions and demands are being made by those who arrogantly assert their authority over our lives, authority over life, authority over our spirits and minds. We want to continue to pretend to be creators of a separate reality. But it's only in fantasy. It's only in dreams. We were not created to be under the spell of dreams and fantasies. We were created to be co-creators, magnificent, free beingness, directly experiencing infinite tapestry of riches, richness of experiencing, completely invulnerable, experiencing that which also is completely invulnerable, in a sublime, supremely blissful, infinite, endless kingdom of unconditional love and harmony. That's what we are created. We are created as that. We are that. That is our inheritance. That is what we're entitled to. We are not created to live in the fantasies of dreams and imaginings. So we're entitled to awaken from all that. We're entitled to shed all of that, shed its grasp, slip through its grasp. We're entitled to live under God's laws and rules only. And all the benefit that brings us, we're entitled to that. Absolutely entitled to that right now. I've always been entitled to it, will always be entitled to it, means we're entitled to it right now. At no point ever were we ever disqualified from that in the slightest degree. We've always had full membership in the country club of the kingdom. Full members in good standing. It makes no difference how we see ourselves in dreams or in fantasy. We can fantasize that we're a wonderful being, or we can fantasize we're a terrible being. It makes absolutely no difference how we see ourselves, or how anyone else sees us, or how we see others in a dream, in fantasy. Our entitlement remains exactly the same. We can never change that fact, however much we try. And oftentimes, by trying to be really, really good in this fantasy of a separate reality, we're actually asserting that this is our home. We say, look how wonderful I feel here. Look how happy I am here. Look how well I've adapted to this place. This must be my home. So we're really asserting separation by trying to be, you know, really goody-good two-shoes, trying to be superior here in some ways. Forget about it. You know, blessed are those who are poor in spirit here. You know, in other words, who look at themselves and say, wow, my personality, everything, it's all messed up. It's not so great. I'm not adapting to this world well at all. I'm not successful here. I don't feel comfortable here. I really feel like I'm a low person on the totem pole here. That's a great blessing, because that means we're not under the delusion that this place is our home, that we're supposed to live under the rules of this dream, of this fantasy. And so we can assert, I'm entitled to live under God's rules. We're much more likely to do that than those who have pretended to somehow adapt to these rules and laws and are supposedly thriving under them. Most of us are not thriving under these rules and laws at all. We're staggering under the weight of it all. We're going under. We're suffering. Those are the fortunate ones. It's time to assert, hey, I'm entitled to live under God's laws and God's rules. I am entitled to live under God's rules only. That is my entitlement. That is my assertion. That is my intention. That is my decree. I'm in alignment with God. You see? Just by saying that, we align with the power of reality. Because we're stating stating a fact. We're stating a truth. instead of a lie, instead of our own prideful, arrogant assertion that somehow we can live under a different set of rules and laws than what we were created to live under. Now, so we're aligning with truth that's powerful. We are entitled to live under God's rules and God's laws entirely, and none other. Not two sets of contradictory laws. Not even two different sets of so-called complementary laws, but just God's laws and God's rules, and that's it. Only that. Because that's all we need. Never more important than right now to make these assertions. And it may take a little, effort to get going. It has for me. But I think it just naturally, somehow something just clicked. And I found an assertion that I said, yeah, resonates, that's it. We don't need to make a whole boatload of assertions. Just find one that has that power like a laser or a rotor hammer. Even if you feel just hammering right through that concrete wall. Going right through it. And banishing the cold, clammy grip of the rules and laws that we've decreed that we're supposed to live under. Getting free of that. And we can do it. We have to do it. Have to do it. It's go time. This is go time. So let us rally at this point. Time to make a rally. And if we can have a rallying point, we have to keep pushing this forward. Don't sit back and react to the world. Be proactive. Intuitively be proactive. The intuition knows when it's go time. Don't listen to the world to tell you when it's go time, because it will tell you too late. After it's consolidated its grip on you, then it'll say it's go time, and what you do, you'll then go towards its agenda. But intuition knows what time it really is. It's time right now. It's go time right now to slip through the grasp of fantasy and delusion. And the harsh, brutal rules and laws that existence insists we all must slave under. So it's go time right now. And let us see what will arise right now. Have the intention. Hold the intention that we want to maximize the go time. We want to maximize our affirmations. We ask for that which will maximize the effectiveness of our affirmations, that we are under no laws but God's laws. Let that be a point of focus, and hold that point of focus. Hold that determination. Resolutely hold on to that. And just spend time holding on to that. And let us push through. Past all obstacles. They're like nothing now. They cannot contravene our will. Focused will. Affirming our entitlements. Affirm our entitlements right now. All right. I will keep working on this. Very great. That's it for this video.